On the line with Peter McGough, our senior writer. Peter, we just got out of one of the more hotly, I don't even want to call it debatable, but it sounded like argumentative Mr. Olympia press conferences in recent past.
Maybe of all time. I mean, we've seen before where there's been a focus on trying to go WWE, but I think the nastiness we saw today wasn't put on. It was genuine, and the nastiness was between Kai and Phil Heath. Most of it, to be honest, coming from Kai.
Yeah, it seemed to be a little bit personal. I was part of one of those controversial press conferences in my last Olympia, 2001, yeah. But it had a lot more to do with the infrastructure, the prize money, the changing of the judges, yeah. the transparency on the scoring. I mean, things that would affect the entire panel, not a one-man conversation. This seemed to be raw, real emotion, where Kai Greene is now fed up with being a first runner-up, being dismissed by the champion, but Phil Heath was very adamant that it's been very disrespectful going back to last year, where Kai Greene was actually signing photographs as the 2013 Mr. Olympia, which we know did not come to pass, but he's done it again in 2014.
Yeah, and then Phil was talking about dedicating this Olympia to his father who died earlier in the year, and Kai interrupted and said, you should have dedicated the first three to your father. That took it to a whole new level. And as it went downhill from there, my thought was, I just wonder what NBC are thinking of this, because this wasn't WWE. This was childish and nasty as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah, it was very reminiscent of Mr. T in Rocky when he was giving the press conference and Mr. T came out really angry and fired up. Definitely had people sitting up and taking notice that Kai Greene had better deliver on the goods, because Kai's throwing a lot out there. Now the question is, in 24 hours, can he back it up? That's the big question.
Well, I think the thing is, I mean, we've seen Kai at previous press conferences almost being asleep, as if it's going to be. We've never seen him this animated. And it wasn't like he was just buzzed for 3 minutes. All the way through, his face, there was one point where he challenged Phil. He was talking about kicking ass. I'll kick your ass now. Now, I don't think he was talking about double biceps. And he was half out of his seat. You know, I think he's really fired up. It's now or never for him. There's going to be fireworks on Friday. When them two stand next to each other, it's going to get very, very physical.
Yeah, and it's interesting because we expected fireworks regardless of all of this. I mean, all this testosterone came out, but there's 17 guys on this stage. A lot of rookies that are just saying, I'm happy to be here, but I'm not sure they signed up for this type of a debate before going out there on the 50th anniversary.
Yeah, Sean Roden probably summed it up by saying it's a pleasure to be here as part of the Kai and Phil show. Yeah. You know, that was a great line. And